Well, you know, thanks to Restaurant Week, foodies from all walks of life can enjoy Boston's best restaurants. Well, why not bring that same affordability to art lovers as well? Art Week, a collection of curated events and experiences throughout the city, highlights the quality and diversity of the arts, culture, and entertainment in Boston. And now, this week-long celebration of creativity strives to give a taste of the arts to everyone for low cost to no cost. President and CEO of the City Performing Arts Center, Joel Spalding, joins us now in the studio to give us an idea of what to expect. Hi, Joel.
Good morning.
I'm so glad you're here.
I'm so glad to be here, Karen.
Talk more about the genesis of Art Week and how it came to be.
I would love to do that. Art Place is a national foundation which is made up of several major foundations such as Ford, Kresge, Rockefeller, so on and so on, National Endowment for the Arts, and actually some major banks got together to pool the money to create places of sort of, you know, creative environments of place, Art Place, and cities. And we were fortunate enough to be asked to submit an application, one of over 1,000. And 100 people were asked to move to the next round, and we came up with this idea of Arts Week, sort of based around Restaurant Week, and lo and behold, we were chosen to be one of 34 that were funded.
That's great.
And that is really great. And so the simple concept is really to try and show the diversity of our city, show the arts in a collaborative way, take a way in which vitality sort of brews in our community, and create wow factors. And the Highland Street Foundation thought that was a good idea, and so they've become the presenting sponsor, and we're getting ready to launch it. And the first one is September 27th through October 6th, and then we do it again in the spring from April 25th to May 4th.
And one of the things that I think I understand about Art Week, it is not just discount to in any gallery. You get an art experience.
You get an art experience that can be free. In fact, there are over 50 events. And if I didn't plug this, my team would be not happy. So you go to artweekboston.org, and you'll have a chance to see over 50 events. Of all those events, 50% of them are free. Several of them are
$20.13.
And some are $40.13. And so if you're going to the Roxbury Open Studios one, you're getting a chance to see Africa Cobra.
Yeah, we
which
have some pictures of that I think we're going to show from Discover Roxbury as you talk about that, because I know that you've made a point of trying, here we are, the pictures of Discover Roxbury right now. You've made a point of trying to make sure that all of the neighborhoods from around the city are represented in this Art Week.
That's correct. And so this is not about selling tickets in a way that you would traditionally do for many of the arts organizations. They had to find a community partner. They had to find ways in which they were trying to do something different. And they had to have a wow factor. And all of them have done it. And so in the Roxbury Open Studios, you've got Chicago visual artists who are celebrating black culture. And you're able to wander down the streets and into the restaurants and do all of that kind of stuff. Or on the opposite side of the coin, one of the things that we're very excited about, as you know, the mayor has really sort of created a way that space and place in Boston is important, and that includes the Strand Theater, which we were very active in providing the first Broadway musical, and now we're partnering with Fiddlehead, that is now the new resident company of the Strand. But they're working with, on their part of Art Place, with Restaurant Laura, and they're going to do Fame Junior. So you go to eat in the restaurant, and these kids, bilingual, get up and sing while you're having dinner.
That's amazing.
And that is a really cool thing.
That's cool. So a lot of these experiences have a cool factor to them, don't they?
That's the whole point of it. And that's the point, to celebrate our community. It's not about a festival that takes place in one spot. This is all over the city, all kinds of access, all kinds of events, and we're really, really very pleased to get it off the ground.
And I know we have some other photos that we're going to run through just to give people a variety of what we'll be experiencing. Transcending is a wonderful exhibit that we're looking at right now. I think we have a few pictures of this coming up. Zarzuela Spanish Opera.
Spanish Opera. How about that?
And then what I'm looking forward to is something called Colors of India.
Colors of India, working with Dover Rug Company. And, you know, it's all very, it's all got great sort of new kind of special partners, which makes this event, I think, really important. And our hope is, Karen, that we're able to make this a success, obviously, in Boston. It takes place in Boston and Cambridge this year. We're hopeful that this could be then statewide. And I think our ultimate goal is to replicate this nationally. So we're really thrilled to launch this as a Boston event, first in the country.
Now, it's all ready to launch now, but there must have been a lot of prep work leading up to it. And Sue is standing, sitting just off camera, listening to us talk about this. I know she's been doing yeoman's work to get it ready.
My chief of staff, Sue Sullivan, has done a fantastic job. To think in 3 months we've been able to create a website, 50 events, get a presenting sponsor in Highland, which is the perfect sponsor because they sponsor Free Fridays, as you know, support the mayor and what he has done in his initiative as an arts mayor for this city and creating place and launching it. And here we go. And how cool is that?
Now, Joe, you have been at the City Performing Arts Center for 25 years now. This is a labor of love for you.
It is.
Why is it important for you to see that the City of Boston has something like Art Week and just take a look at the bigger landscape of arts in Boston, where it's come and where you'd like to see it go?
Well, I have this simple statement that I think the arts keeps us a civilized society. And I think the arts, and no matter what you do, no matter where it is, fits in all cultures. So the ability to open up that right side of the brain and have a creative environment, a creative event, makes you a better human being. And whether we're working with young kids, as you know we do, or we're just simply presenting all the different kinds of shows we do, I know that we're making a difference. And so I have the best job, really, in the entire city, and I'm very pleased that I've been now into my 26th year.
Okay. Where is Boston ranking now in terms of art for the community, in terms of what you see when you travel to other cities?
Well, I think, you know, we're also sort of known as the Athens of America, and most other cities look up to what we do. I think we've had a little overplay of a number of almost too many venues, not enough programming, now almost too much programming. Do we have the audience to make it work? The key is the diversity in the city. So there's never a day, unlike several cities that I go to visit, where there isn't many things happening. And just having Jungle Book that you've talked about as this being a wonderful piece that's brand new coming to the Boston market is really exciting at the same time that we're launching Art Week.
When I first came here to Boston to attend college, used to be able to keep up with all the arts events, but now there's just so much to do.
Totally. And you know, you and I have talked about it before, but you know, prior to the September 11th, 2001, 77% of our tickets were 6 months or more in advance. Today, 70% of our tickets are the week of the show, 2 weeks before the show, or 20% on the day of the show.
Yeah.
So everybody's a last minute. There's so much to do. That's okay. That provides what makes Boston, on Greater Boston, such a wonderful place to be.
Well, Joe Spaulding, I'm looking forward to participating in Art Week. WCVB is a media sponsor.
They are indeed, and we are thrilled.
We are happy to be working with you, and we have an experience called Design at 5 that folks will find on the Art Week calendar. So, Joe, thanks again for being here to share this with us.
Karen, thank you, and thank you for your support.
Okay, WCVB, proud to support Art Week, which runs from September 27th through October 6th. Be sure to check it out. Need more art? Well, the Cooper Community Garden and Education Center on Fort Hill in Roxbury will house a permanent exhibit celebrating pioneers of African descent, both past and present, who have made a difference in Massachusetts and the world. Portraits of these history makers were created by a gifted team of high school and college-age graphic designers at the South Boston-based Artists for Humanity. We're going to leave you now with just some of their images. And to find out more about everything we featured on today's program, go to our page at WCVB.com. Have a great rest of your day.